Hey guys, it's Corey. Just about to start the tile cleaning here out at the lake. I did a huge stretch and clean yesterday, but I didn't cover any of it because it was too big and it was taking forever to get done. So today I'm doing tile, which will be something I can show more of. Let me show you the terrain here. Not extremely dirty at all, I don't believe, and it shouldn't be that big of an issue. But let me show you what I'm cleaning with and kind of explain the whole process here to all the guys that just found a chance. I'm cleaning the tile. I think they said it's been here about 8 or 10 years or so. It's got the thin grout line here. Pretty dirty. And we're gonna take it back to something around like that, basically. So that's where it's not walked on, it's clean. You can see how it dirties up here as you get out into it. So what I've got mixed up here is one bottle of LA's Totally Awesome. I've got about a half a gallon of hydrogen peroxide, a decent shot of a floor stripper just to boost it, and then there's some water in there as well. So, you know, everything that I named is really inexpensive, so you don't have to watch how much you put in there. You just want to make sure you have it strong enough that you get it the first time. So I'm going to spray all this down and let it dwell, and then I haven't decided exactly what I'm going to use. I'm going to start out with the green brush, you know, and I've also brought a red brush, and then I've got a black and a green pad in the event I want to use one of those. I'm backing everything away with this, and then I spray down vinegar and I run the challenger over it with these guys here as the finishing touch. But I'll try to cover all of that as I go. First thing is to spray everything down. We've got this table with 99 legs to contend with, and to wait till the guy gets back and help me move it. If I drag it, they tend to want to bend or something. I don't know exactly what's going on with the table. But I'm going to spray this down and let it dwell, and then I'll show some scrubbing. People tend to like the scrubbing aspect of this for some reason, so we got plenty of that today. So let me get it all pre-treated, and then I'll be back. All right, if I can set up the camera and still scrub, that would be great. It looks like this the green is doing a pretty good job here. The green is less... It's more of a limber. It's not as stiff a bristle as the red is.
going. Huh?
Oh, it's good to do that. Yeah, it's doing good.
All right, you ever just get out of your way and I'll...
Just a minute. Probably about 3 hours, yeah. In a minute, I might need some help with this table,
okay?
Let me scrub around it real quick, and then we'll probably
scrub it. Listen, I'm not
gonna. I can't really drag it because the
you're
legs don't want to. Don't want to be
anywhere. What I'm going to be doing is placing that table here for the next few weeks, if not this weekend. Yeah, it's just like a hard table for you. The rental is coming out. Getting rid of this unit too.
Oh, you're getting rid of this unit?
No, not this. This long
unit
here, getting glass out. Yeah, that stuff looks pretty good. You got a nice little setup here.
Yeah, I've been at it a while. I've been in different ways throughout the course of this business.
And the other thing that might help is to help to do the scalp. It's extremely heavy.
Are the scalp is heavy?
Yeah, it's kind of inside silk.
The tile is really dirty over here. The tile itself is dirty.
Yeah, that's a high traffic zone right here.
It's got a coarse feel to it. It's not slick like a lot of tile is.
Is there a particular brand or type of shop treatment that you recommend?
I use a product from Home Depot. It's Stone Lab is what it's called. I think it's called Stone Lab. They have one that costs $25 a gallon and one that costs $99 a gallon. Good choice.
Is that a little deep pump?
Do what?
I wonder if one of those big pots.
Let me turn this off and scoot that table.
I'll be on the patio when you need me, just call me, okay?
All right. guys, I only showed one step there. I only showed the scrubbing on this particular part. I just ran the Challenger over it and I got everything else back off. There's one area over there that's missing some grout. I'm gonna wait for this to dry completely in just a little bit here, and then I'm gonna scoot this table back, and then I'll show some more, you know, different steps over here. I'll show the scrubbing and some more vacuuming and stuff over here, but I've gotta get a hand with the table. I can't drag it. The legs try to fold under and break. So I've gotta get the floor dry enough that I can get the gentleman to help me carry that over there. And then I think he's gonna leave for a little bit. And then I can clear this area out here, and we can shoot some more video that shows more of what's going on. It's amazing what a difference the Challenger makes when you run it over with vinegar. It can see it lightening the grout line even more. There's a few areas over there that I'm gonna have to go back. What I do is I carry this guy with me here. You know, the stuff is just too close for you to reach. That's what I carry this guy for. I think it's about 10 bucks. They've been around for like, ever since the beginning, been around about 20 years. Cheaper all the time. But that's what you do. You give it a little squirt of ammonia, and then you run that over it and tallow it right quick, and you got that little tiny short piece of grout that you can't reach otherwise. All right, I'm gonna let you go for a few, and then I'll be back showing some stuff going on over in this area here. All right, I'm letting a gentleman get off the phone here before I bother him about putting this table back here. This is drying, and the more it dries, the more the grout lightens up. Some of the guys on the channel, you know, that watch have asked questions, and you know, you have to convey to your customers that the grout is going to dry at all different rates depending on the humidity, what the AC set at, how much airflow you've got. Basically, this shows that you've got everything out of the grout line. Now, certain areas will be wetter, like right here, it's still wet, so it looks a little darker. Here, it's dry. So basically, if you carry a fan, you know, it's justifiable for the client to wonder, you know, what it's gonna look like when it's dry. So you can dry an area and basically show them. And really what you wanna do is you wanna pick an area that's really, really, really dirty. And that's always the kitchen. So you get over here and you put the fan down, and I haven't here yet, But basically you put the fan down in the kitchen and dry and show them that you've got the absolute dirtiest area clean. And then they understand that as everything dries, it's gonna lighten up, you know. And I basically work my way toward the door. So everything that I just finished is still gonna be a little bit darker when I leave the person's house. But you've just got to, you know, your customer doesn't know. You've got to coach them along. You know, they don't know these things, and it's justifiable for them to wonder, you know, did he do a good job? And they won't know until an hour or so goes by that you did. It still will have a dirty look to it because it's wet, even though you've got everything out of it. You've soaked the grout line, and the tile is not porous, and the grout is. It's like concrete. If you spray water on concrete, you know, as it dries, it will lighten back up. It's the same thing with grout. So you have to explain that to your client, that way they understand. And it's also good to go and point out issues like this before you get started. I never had an issue when I was cleaning with high PSI, but it is possible. But generally, there's nothing you're gonna do outside of taking a hammer to it that's gonna knock the grout out. But, you know, it's good to point out stuff like that before you start, just so you don't get in some kind of, you know, issue. You know, somebody saying you did this and you didn't. But anyway, trying to cover some stuff that maybe other guys don't cover on their channel, help you guys a little more. Anyway, I haven't put the fan on it yet. I'm just waiting for it to dry as is. The place is so small, I turn the fan on, and I think that's all you'll hear in here. It's a really small place. All right, I just wanted to cover some of that while I was waiting. I've got somebody texting me about their carpet stretching, so it's a full-time job. All day, you're working, stopping, taking phone calls, scheduling people, then back to work again, then stop, then you film some more, then you go home and you edit. So it's a never-ending job. It really feels good when you lay down at night or you take one day a week off. All right, guys, I got some stuff moved here, so, and this job is small, crowded, and kind of in my own way. So now, I'm gonna take the full one here, and we're gonna spray and do everything. I might even move the couch and do that at the same, I don't know. Anyway, it's gotta dwell, you know, a good 15, at least 15 minutes. You know, and don't hurry it. You know, if you hurry it, you may not get it clean. You've got to give the cleaner time to work. The cleaner itself, it really doesn't require that much agitation. If you have your cleaner mixed right with high enough pH in it, it'll burst through. But you agitate just so you don't miss. But what you don't want to do is add like citrus solvent to it. Citrus solvent's a little bit oily, and it can make problems for you when you're trying to get that last little sheen off of the tile. So you want to do it with high pH, not with a solvent. You're welcome to try me on there if you want to give it a shot, and you'll see what I mean. If you can do it without a solvent, that's what you want to do. More stripper will do as much as any solvent will. With just the high pH of 14, we'll get the job done. And I mixed a little of that in here, not much, just a little, just so I wouldn't miss. I didn't know how this tiny grout line is gonna work out, or I wasn't sure. So if you're not sure, use too much, not too little. The chemicals that I recommend you use are extremely inexpensive, so you don't have to feel like you're going broke and spraying down a chemical, because you're not. LA's Totally Awesome cost $1, and you can buy 5 gallons of floor stripper for I think $32. Peroxide at Sally Beauty Supply, if you're a member, runs you about $5 a gallon. So you're not going to go broke. Like a long time ago when I used to do this with a spinner and a truck mount, I was paying about $35 a gallon for wiper brand, you know, which worked great, but, you know, the whole time you're spraying it down, that's taking off your bottom line, because your cleaner is so expensive. You're making money for the guy that's selling you chemical rather than just for yourself. All right, now I'm turning this guy around here. You can see you're looking for a coat base. I turned the fan off. You want to make sure the fan's off so you're not drying this. You want it to soak in the grout line. So I've got this part of it sprayed, and I'm wearing slip resistant shoes. I need to put an Amazon store together where you can buy all the stuff that I use off Amazon. A friend of mine in California mentioned these shoes, and I've been wearing them ever since. And they're they're not as slippery as regular shoes. You can still slip if you really, you know, run and skid with them, you can still slip. But you're not too likely to have your foot golf underneath you with these guys on. They're only about $30. You know, this is a leather couch over here, so you want to make sure you're not dousing it with a high pH cleaner. It'll ruin the leather. And you also want to make sure you're not so much with a high pH when you get around kitchen appliances that are stainless. Now, if you're using something acidic and you get it on stainless appliances, you can make rust spots in the peeler, so you want to be careful with that. All issues that I've dealt with in the past 20 years, and there's nobody to tell you what you can and can't do. starting to put dirt footprints back in the flooring again from all the soil that's coming off of the tile. That's marble on the fireplace, so if you leave us more, no, that's granite. That's granite. Granite and marble both have a sealer on it that you don't want to get anything too high of a pH on because it can take it off. So, don't avoid that. It's not dirty anyway. We'll try to stay away from there. Now we've got that sleeper sofa right here. So we're about to see whether or not I can move it or not. Keep in mind it's slippery, so I don't know if I'll be able to scoot it. But we'll find out here. Fall down. Don't do much editing, so if I did, you'll probably see it. Just the couch, so we're moving it. The bed, we're not going to move the bed. Nobody walks under the bed, so we're going to measure it around the bed, and that's how we're going to put the square footage in that case. Nobody's going to take the bed apart. Making sure I've got all of the tile. Looks like I found another spot here that was dry. Oh my, it's weird. All right, I'm going to do some scrubbing now. I'm going to let this dwell for a little bit. I'm going to come back with the Oreck. And I may switch out different types of scrubbing. I may use one of the pads too. I don't know. I've never got to use one before, so I might give it a shot here. All right, a little scrubbing here. This area is not that bad. still watching the grout dry over here, so I decided I'm not going to change anything as far as the way I'm scrubbing it. See right there where the grout has dried, how white it is. I'm not going to be able to, not going to be able to top that, you know, as far as scrubbing with anything else. So I'm going to stay with the green brush here. Seems to be working well. Nothing wrong with switching stuff up, but it's not going to be here. Right, scrub one more. I'm gonna scoot some stuff around, so I'm gonna continue scrubbing, and basically I'm not gonna come back until it's time for me to vacuum some of this away. I'm not gonna cover all of this here. Mainly the two ingredients that I'm suggesting you use here, the main ingredients are LA's Totally Awesome and hydrogen peroxide. That's the two main ingredients. So that will get the job done on this particular job. I didn't need to put the other product in it, the floor stripper, but I did anyway. So I think I'm going to probably give credit to the LA's Totally Awesome when it comes time to tag and label the video. Anyway, I'll be back in a bit. All right, now we're going to recover some of the solution. Show part of it. Thank you. recovers pretty fast. All right, now we're gonna try to get the rest of that. And then we're gonna towel over it with the challenger and vinegar. Camera off and get what's behind the couch, and we'll come back with a challenger and do the final step. All right, we will record some of this here. I am running the challenger over it now. I sprayed down vinegar. This makes one final swipe across the grout line. It does knock more out of there. It'll get stuff that the vacuum will leave behind. my towel grabbed, and I'll be back in a minute. Guys, I'm finally done here. This has taken entirely too long, and it has been one of the most difficult grout cleanings I've probably done in a very long time, and I don't know exactly why. I don't know exactly why it was so difficult. It started out cleaning like it was gonna be just fine. Then I come back over some of the areas over here to get those and started realizing there was some stuff that would still come out. And I'm thinking it's because it was a grout job that was done terribly bad. We've got high and low grout. So scrubbing it was difficult to get a uniform scrub on all of it. Generally, your grout lines are a little wider than that. And there's so many dips in and out of it that it made it difficult for me to scrub and extract. So I went over everything. I started doing it, you know, with the small scrubber. And then I basically just, I took the Oreck and went over everything and then toweled over it. So it has just been so difficult. I've done different ones that were difficult for different reasons that you could really put your finger on, and this one I can't tell you exactly why. But I've been over everything multiple times, and now it looks like I'm putting footprints back on my own work here. So it's been very difficult. I got down in here and it started drying, and it was drying irregular. I won't even hardly focus on it, but I finally got it to where I feel like I won. But I don't know exactly what I'm taking away. This is still drying here, so because I went over this twice. At any rate, I've got to pack up my tools and get out of here. I haven't even measured what I've done yet. I spent every bit of time scrubbing on it. All right, guys, this is one of those one in a thousand. It's weird how tile, I've done it many different ways in 20 years. Tile is one of the things that if anything is gonna get you, it's gonna be tile and grout. Carpet, not so much, but tile and grout, there's things you can uncover that you can't do anything about. You know, like grout, somebody went and they regrouted something that's not the same color, then you clean it and expose it, and it's just, every once in a while, you're gonna run into a tile and grout job that's gonna absolutely kick your ass. And, you know, for me to put it on my channel, you know, it's gotta look good. And I just, at this point, I've never done one that I felt this way about. You know, it's always been like something you really put your finger on. Like, well, they put floor finish on it, and that's why it was so difficult. This one, there was teeny tiny thin grout lines. There was grout lines that were missing. There was grout lines that one piece of tile was really high, one of them was really low, and they were pinched together really close. So it's just, the only thing I can think of is that it wouldn't scrub right, it wouldn't extract right. And when I was going over it with the Challenger at the end, it wouldn't reach in and hit those lines the way it usually does. So, and at that point I switched to the Oreck and I did everything, but it is still just incredibly hard. I don't know why. I cranked up the power of the pre-spray to a bunch more four stripper in it. Anyway, I've got to get some stuff picked up. You know, this is one of those jobs where you've got to go down the hall, down the elevator, across the parking garage to get everything to and from here. So I've still got several trips to make, and I've got to make sure my feet are clean when I walk back into this white tile and white grout. And I don't footprint up my, you know, all my hours worth of work here. Thanks for watching, guys, and God bless.